Let me just go through this. You have been asked by the town committee to create a promotional video for next year's 4th of July celebration. The video has to be exactly 30 seconds, 45 seconds, or 60 seconds. And that's because that's how long commercials are sold in. You need to tell a story about a 4th of July celebration using pictures, videos, talking, music, and possibly more. Your story or your commercial will need to include the following: at least 10 pictures or videos. The video should be landscape, not portrait. And you can see here's an example of landscape where the phone is turned sideways. And this is an example of portrait. Think of landscape like you're sitting on the couch at home watching TV. There should not be black bars on the side or the top of the video. Your video should include music and or narration. Narration is optional, but music is necessary. The following information needs to be included in text format: the 4th of July celebration, July 4th, 2022, at the City Center Green, and dress in red, white, and blue. You're going to upload your finished video to Google Classroom. Let me demonstrate how to do this inside of WeVideo. First of all, you're going to go to WeVideo.com and log in with your school account. When you are logged into your school account, it may ask you to start a new project. If it does, you click on Start New Project. It will bring you here. And once you get here, let's go through how to create this video. First of all, I would like to point out what you can see in this area. Up here in the upper left-hand area, this is where you can see where media will be stored. Right now, I am inside of a folder, so you may not see the back on yours. You may just see an empty space here. Up at the top, there's a button that says Stock Media, and here you can type in and you can search for different types of media, and you can search for videos, images, or audio, which is sound. My media is media that you're using in your project. Text is where you can add in different texts into your video, and you can scroll down to see all of the different options. Audio. Here you can find different sounds, and you can see when you click on that, it has sound effects, free music, and then it has premium music. There is also a transition tab. This transition tab will let you go from one picture or one video to the next, and it's what it looks like as it switches between the two. Backgrounds are different backgrounds that you can put inside of your video. For this project though, what we need to do is we need to find some patriotic music, some pictures, and some video. I am briefly going to demonstrate how to do this, and then you are going to work on your own to create a 30 second, 45 second, or 60 second video advertising an event on the 4th of July. The first thing I would like to do is add in some music. I am going to click on the audio tab. Actually, let me go to stock media. And underneath stock media, I'm going to change all to audio. And I'm going to type in patriotic. And I'm going to find different sounds here. I can go through, I can click on one, and I can listen to it. I think I'm going to start with the Star Spangled Banner. And I click on it. And it previews the sound over here in the side. So this is your preview window. You're going to see what you're working on. And then when you find something you like, you're going to drag it down here to this area. This area is called your timeline. And you can see there are different tracks set up. I have video one, I have video two, and I have audio one. So I can click up here on the Star Spangled Banner. I can drag it down here to audio one. And here you can see all these little lines. These are the sound waves. And so you can actually see where the sound gets much louder. Click up here, this blue triangle or blue square with the blue triangle down here. This is your playhead, and it'll show you where you are in your timeline. So I can click on play. Now, if I only want a portion of the song, I can actually move my cursor so I'm right over the edge, and I can click and drag, and that will trim the beginning, or I can trim the end as well. Now, for this demonstration, I just want this segment right here. So I am going to trim all the way to that segment. And I'm going to put it here. So I can hear the sound there. And now that I have my sound in there, I would like to put some video or pictures. And I think I'm actually going to make it a little bit longer because it's a little short there. So I think I'm going to incorporate this part here. In fact, because the video has to be 30 seconds, I think that I am going to make it that long, and then I will have text that shows up for the last few seconds to make it the full length. So I have the sound. Now what I need to do is add in some videos and pictures. To do that, I can click up on stock media and I can change this to, let's say, pictures, and I can find some pictures. Again, I have patriotic in the search, so I can find different pictures that I want, or I can switch and I can choose videos. So for the videos, I can choose a couple of different ones. I think for this case, I am going to choose firework. And I'm going to watch through. I can find different fireworks. And there you can see there's one firework, but there's no sound to it. Many of these in the stock footage may not have sound. So I'm just going to drag this down anyway. I put it onto video one. And so you can see my video is playing above my sound beneath. So I've added a video, I've added sound. I'm going to add a picture, but this time I'm going to import my own media. So I click on my media and I choose import, and it says drag and drop media files or browse to select. So in this case, I am going to browse to select. And I am going to bring in a couple of pictures that I have already downloaded. And I am actually going to bring in a video. I click import, and you can see here it has the different pictures and it has the different video. This is a video that I brought in. So I can come in and I'm going to adjust my video length here just by dragging it. In fact, I'm going to make it come to the end. I would like to put in, I have a video here of the flag waving. I'm going to put the video on video two. I don't want it on the same track. You can, I just personally just don't want it there now. I like to put it above so I can trim it to the right size, and then I can drag it down just to make sure it's the right size. Now, if I were to play this, you can see the video playing with the sound in the background, and I can move forward, and I would like it to have some sort of transition between these two shots. So I have this video play and it just kind of cuts there. I would like to have a transition between these two shots. So if I click up here on transitions, I can choose all the different ones. And in this case, I'm just going to choose paper airplane, see what it looks like. And now I can see I have that there. And I can go through, I can listen, I could try matching things up to the sound. But what I'd like to do now is I would like to add in a picture over the top of this. And actually, I think I'm going to add the picture at the end just so you can see how to do this. So we've added in video. I'm going to go to my media and I am going to put in this picture. I'm going to drag it down and I put it up here. Now, if you notice, this picture has black bars on both sides, or black columns. And the reason it has that is because this picture was not taken in landscape mode. It was taken in portrait mode. And so I need to figure out how to make this picture not look that way. To do that, I can click on the picture, and then I can come up here. And I can, first of all, you can click on FX and you can change the way it looks. I'm not going to do that right now. But what you can do is if you double click on it, it will open up your settings and you can choose different settings. For example, you can choose scale and you can see scale allows you to zoom in on the picture. And this only works if you have a high resolution picture. If you have a low resolution picture, it will be very blurry. So I'm going to go ahead and scale up. Now position, I can make this higher or lower. So if I want it to be a little bit lower, I can type in different numbers. Sorry, X is left and right, Y is up and down. And so you can see, you can go through and you can get this picture more where you want it to be. And you can kind of mess around to see what you want it to look like. There's also the option to crop, where you can cut off parts. This one, you can animate it. We're not going to go through that right now. Well, I'll do it briefly. You can click on start. So let's say I wanted it to start right there, and then I wanted it to end. I could zoom in even more. And so it's going to start and it's going to end. And I hit save changes. I can come back here. And you can see it is moving. So again, to edit the quality or the way the picture is, the settings, you can click on the picture. You can choose the start, what you want it to look like at the start. Again, you do not want to have the black columns on the side. And then you can click on what you want it to end on. And you can change the X and Y. And then this tab, we're not going to worry about today. This is if you wanted to remove a green screen or a color and change the background. And this one, you can change the quality of the picture. We're not going to focus on that today. Once you are done editing, you can click on Save Changes. And now you have all of the information that you need. And we need to go to 30 seconds. So I have my picture here. I might just trim it down just a little bit so we have the picture. We have that. And I would like to have the text fade in up above and stay while this goes to black. So I'm going to click on the text. I can go through and I can find a text that I really like. There's a bunch of different options. For this one, I'm just going to choose this one. I drag it up above. I'm going to actually match it so it goes right to 30 seconds. And I can move my playhead here to 30 seconds. Now, if it's not exact to the hundredth of a frame right here, that is perfectly fine. And it actually looks like the frames are not set up to hundreds. So there are 30 pictures, approximately 24 to 30 pictures inside of every second of video. So I'm going to get it as close to 30 as I can, and it's okay if you go over a little bit afterwards. So I have this. I can now double click on it. Again, I can transform. I can click on this, and I can change the text. And this is where you're going to get your text. Now you can put the text in any way you want. I'm just going to copy it all and put it inside here. And let's see if it will let me put it on multiple lines. It doesn't look like, so I may have to choose a different one. Let me just choose this as Danbury. I'm going to call it the 4th of July celebration. And then I'm going to delete this. And I can change the size. So you can go through and you can explore the different settings of this. I'm not going to spend too much time on this. Just so you can see how it works, you can drag it around to where you want it. So I can put it there and I can click on Save Changes. Now, if you need more video area, you can actually come up here and you can click on the plus and you can actually add another audio track or a video track. I'm going to add a track and I could put in another title underneath here. And maybe I'm going to put one in. Let's see if there's a better one with more details. I think I will put this one in. And again, I'm going to line it up to 30 seconds. I might delete the one that did not work how I had hoped it would. So again, this is a lot of trial and error. You're trying to see what looks good, and it is okay if you have to undo and redo something just to make it work. It's a lot about experimenting. So I'm going to double click on this, and here I can just put in the different text. And I'm going to I'm separating this out so that it fits on each of the lines. And you can change the fonts. I'm going to keep the fonts there. And I do not need to have that. Let's see. So it does take some time to go through. I'm going to delete that and just put a dash. Actually, I'll just say July 4th. And now I have that. So once you have your video finished, you can go through. And mine is 30 seconds. Let me get it right at the 30 seconds. It's very close to 30 seconds. So it is okay if you're not exactly there. Try to be within a second or two of 30 seconds. Now that I am finished, I am going to click on finish. I'm going to give it a title. I would call it your name. 4th of July. I click on set. Now it's going to give me some options. I can export just the audio. I don't want that. I want the video. And it's going to let me do HD, which is a higher quality. It stands for high definition, and you can see the resolution here, or SD. In this case, I'm going to choose HD. And I would like to export this to Google Drive. So I'm going to click on my Google Drive. And then it says mark export as public. Turn this off so that your work is just your own and it's not public. You can choose a thumbnail here. And I'm going to choose this thumbnail of the flag. And I click on export. It may take it some time to export. Once it's done exporting, you're going to upload this video to Google Classroom. I look forward to seeing your creativity.